Hi there, I'm Manpreet and I make book related videos on this channel. If you like books, make sure you subscribe and follow me on my social media. Today's video is about the new releases in May, and trust me, there were so many new releases in May 2017 that you cannot even imagine. But I have made some effort to pick up only the ones which I feel interested about, which are very much hyped, or you know, which are being talked about by a lot of other booktubers as well. So it's a combination of some books by Indian authors and some books by foreign authors, and without further ado, I should start with this video. Before that, I have a slight explanation to give to my existing subscribers. If you haven't subscribed me yet, you should subscribe right now. So the explanation is about my upload schedule. I make a video every odd day, and since like 5 months, like since January 2017, I haven't missed a day except for once in a month. And at the same time, I also make a lot of bonus videos, which are actually review videos, book review videos. So this month what happened was I missed 2 days, which is very unusual of me, and I have to explain why I did that. It was because of the t-shirt thing. Yes, actually I had to go to my home because my dad had to get operated and I had to help him with that. And I pre-shot all my videos. So there were like 9 videos which I shot on the same day in the same t-shirt, and my editor was not available. So I had to edit those videos as well. And when I started editing those videos, what happened was I saw myself for hours and hours in the same t-shirt, and I felt so sick of myself that I went through a, you know, booktube block where I could not post more videos. So that's what happened. I'm really sorry about that. I'm in a different shirt today, which is very new and refreshing, and I'm very sure it won't happen again. I'm really sorry about that. Anyway, let's get started with this video and let me show you the 12 books I picked which are like really popular new releases of 2017. The first book is Baaz by Anuja Chauhan, which was released on May 1. Now this author, I really loved her The House That BJ Built, which I have reviewed on this channel as well. And you should definitely check out her writing because she writes strong stories with characters you will fall in love with. Seriously, I do planks only because of Bonu Singh. And she also has like really good stories which make you feel happy and sad, and you know, just funny good stories. So I really like her writing, and this was her new release. I definitely wanted to pick it up. Also, all the books which I have included in this whole video are the ones which you guys have asked me to review. HarperCollins India contacted me and they were like, would you like a copy of this book? I was like, yes, yes, yes. So they gave me this copy. Thank you so much for that. And I'll review this first. My dog always has to ruin the framing, and he just doesn't know how difficult it is to set up a camera without a flip screen on it. Anyway, yes, I'm really excited to read and review this book. They are not paying me for reading or reviewing it, but they just sent me the copy. So I'm really, really thankful for that. The second book by an Indian author is Sita, the Warrior of Mithila by Amish. Now, first of all, this author changed his name from Amish Tripathi to Amish. Do you know that it creates a lot of confusion with the genre Amish and whatever you call it and your name? So this book follows Sita and her journey from being an adopted child to the Prime Minister and to finding her calling. And I am really excited to read this book. So many of you have asked me to review all the Amish Tripathi books. I had the first Shiva trilogy, but I gave it to somebody, never got it back, so I'll have to buy it again. And I'll review that one as well, and I'll review this series as well, so wait for that. Also, do let me know if it baffles you that this book is going to be released on 29 May and it has hit the bestseller list already. Like, already. It is so popular. Number 3 book is The Boy Who Loved by Dujoy Datta. First of all, why is every book named like The Girl on the Train, The Girl on That, The Boy on That? So many Indian authors are doing this kind of titles. Dujoy, I love the titles you make, but this is not the one I really love, okay? But this book is actually about this guy who is guilt laden because of how he let his closest friend drown in a swimming pool. And fast forward, he meets a girl and he is kind of falling in love with her, but the old skeletons are going to come up and make this story very dark, edgy, quirky and different, which I really like because it gives a good vibe to me. Last year I read World's Best / Best Boyfriend by the same author, and I kind of liked it, but this book gives me a very good vibe, so I may pick it up. This book is again releasing on 29 May if you wanted to know. Number 4 book is by the most loved author of the country, that is Ruskin Bond, and his book's name is Love Among the Bookshelves. Like, the title is so perfect for the people who love to read books. And this is a kind of memoir slash anthology where Ruskin Bonds, you know, takes up stories from his life. And he also discusses a lot of books and classics that have been forgotten. And I really love the books which talk about books. So I'm gonna read it very soon. The book is releasing on 24 May, and if anybody of you want to send me any book from this list before I buy it myself, follow me on Instagram for the update, then please go ahead and do it. I'll be really happy for that. This is like begging on camera. I'm just trying to save some money to buy my vlogging camera, okay? Anyway, with book number 5, we start the foreign authors, and some of the books are the ones which I really want to read, and some of the books are the ones which are very much hyped, which all the booktubers are recommending, and I just thought I should inform you guys that these books are releasing. You can pick them up if you want. So let's get started with that. Book number 5 is Come Sundown by Nora Roberts. Now, I have heard a lot of great things about this author, and it baffles me and it surprises me that even next month she is releasing a book. How can she write so much when I cannot even start my first book? Anyway, this is a murder mystery where there is a woman who is running her family's resort, and her childhood crush comes back to the place, and then there is a murder, and her childhood crush is under the radar of the police because they think he's the murderer, and then there is this mystery of this woman's aunt getting lost or disappearing a couple of years ago, and it may be connected to this murder. So this is what the murder mystery is about. I cannot reveal anything else because I don't know anything else. But I'm really excited to read this book. And this book is releasing on May 30th. Number 6 book is releasing on May 31. And this is the final book in the series of 7 books called Clifton Chronicles by Jeffrey Archer. Now this series is really, really popular. And the author is like, everybody's like, have you read Jeffrey Archer? I'm like, no. So this is the expression you get from the readers who have read Jeffrey Archer. So this author is supposed to be really good. And I really want to catch up on the, you know, Jeffrey Archer bandwagon. So I'm really considering to buy the series because now it's ending. I tend to buy the series when they end so that I do not have to wait for the next book if I don't want to. So I'm a very control freak, you know. So this is the book that is releasing, and if you love Jeffrey Archer, pick it up. Number 7 book that has already released on May 2 is Into the Water by Paula Hawkins. Now if you don't know, The Girl on the Train by Paula Hawkins, which was supposedly her first book and it's so popular, is a book of the month. And we are going to have a discussion of this book on May 31st. That was just me self-promoting our book club. But anyway, this book, Into the Water by Paula Hawkins, is set in a place where, you know, there are two bodies found. One of a teenager, one of a single mother, in the same river, in the same summer. Maybe they are connected, maybe they are not. We do not know what will happen because such books should never be discussed unless you all have read the book. So we are not going to discuss about it, but I'm really excited to buy this book because already so many of you have asked me, Gunpreet, have you read this book? Please review this book. I will do it. I'm very excited to read this one. And I really love it when you guys ask me to review books, so keep doing that. Do keep in mind, there are authors who make fake accounts and then ask me to review the book so that I will feel like, you know, my readers and my viewers ask me to review the book and I won't charge from them. That doesn't work. I know every single viewer of mine by my heart, so you cannot fool me, okay? Number 8 book that released on May 2 was A Court of Wings and Ruin by Sarah J. Maas. Now guys, I have been crushing over this author now because so many of you have talked about it. Christine made a video about this book releasing, so many. Jesse made a video about this book releasing, and I'm like, oh my god, I haven't read any book by Sarah J. Maas and I should do that. A lot of you have asked me to do that as well, and I'm just blabbering. This book is the third book in the Court of Thorns and Roses series, and it's really, really popular and people are like crazy about it. So this has already released, and I feel like the people who are actually very crazy about it have already read it, but I'm late to make this video. I can't do anything about it. Number 9 book is Always and Forever Lara Jean by Jenny Han. Now I have read P.S. I Still Love You by Jenny Han, I guess. Yeah. And that was the second book after To All the Boys I've Loved Before, and I liked that book, but it was so fast and, you know, it was just like an okay book for me. But I've heard great things about Jenny Han, and her writing is actually really good. It is just that sort of book which you want to sit and read and then enjoy and then forget. So that didn't please me because I like to live with the stories forever. So that didn't happen with that book, but I'm really hopeful about this book because a lot of people are talking about it, positively talking about it. You can also have negative discussions. For example, there is this one book which is not in this video, And I have made a conscious effort to not make it a part of this video of this Booker Prize winner who thinks that Punjab and all their places are not a part of India. And I feel like if I was born in Pakistan, I would kill myself right now. So yeah, if you're a Pakistani, please don't be offended. I love that my Punjab is a part of India. I love my country. And if anybody says bad things about it, I hate that person. I'm never gonna read their books. So if you're gonna hate me for not reading these writings by this author who won Booker Prize and she's releasing a new book, so she wanted publicity, so she's gonna attack her own country. I'm not going to do that. I'm never going to do that. So this book is not a part of this book. And if you know, I didn't even make a conscious effort to name this author because that's the kind of hatred I have for people who hate my country. All the people who know me from my school time, I also have issues with my country, but there is a difference between, you know, having issues with your country and trying and hoping for them to get resolved, and there's a difference between trying to, you know, bring down your own country because you think other country is better. So there's a lot of difference. And the other side is not the one I appreciate. Number 10 book is When Dimple Met Rishi by Sandhya Menon. Now, I am not sure if it's an Indian author, because the thing is, this author seems to be an Indian, but if she lives in US, she's a US author. I'm not the person who says Lily Singh is an Indian when she herself says that she's a Canadian. But this book is being talked about by a lot of booktubers, and a lot of booktubers have said good things about it. It's a very contemporary, nice, cool read. I have heard that, so I may read this book, because a lot of you have asked me that, Manpreet, have you read it? Manpreet, please review it. So I'll do that. Not very soon, because this list is going to be followed in this chronological manner. Yeah, I think I said that right. So that's that. The book is releasing on May 30th, if you wanted to know. Now on May 23rd, which is today, which is a very special day for me, but I'm still working on making this video because it's an upload date. Anyway, on this day, the second book in the Dark Artifices series by Cassandra Clare is releasing. So this is the second book after Lady Midnight, that is Lord of Shadows. And a lot of people are crazy about it. I'm still on the third book in the Mortal Instruments series, trying to read the first book in the Infernal Devices series. And I'll catch up very soon. Lastly, I have a book that was released on May 2, and I want to talk about it for a long, long time, because I'm currently in love with the author and the world he has built, because it's a middle grade fantasy series, that is the second book in the Trials of Apollo series. Yeah, by Rick Riordan. Now, I just finished reading the fourth book in the Percy Jackson series, and I love this book, and this one is a series which is about this god, Apollo, who has been sent to Earth in the form of a teenage boy, and he is trying his best to reclaim his place as a god in the Olympus. Now, this book has a mix of Greek mythology and Roman mythology, because the Roman mythology thing has a villain out of it, if I said that right. And I am really, really excited to read all the books by Rick Riordan. They are really good, to be honest. When I read the first two books in the Percy Jackson series, I wasn't impressed. But with the third book, I'm in totally love with them. I would definitely recommend you guys to read it. That's it, guys. These are the books that are releasing in May 2017 or have already released and are being loved or being really hyped, or are the ones which I'm really excited about. So I hope you like this video, and there was no way I could have, you know, included all the books that are releasing in May, all the books in English that are releasing which are in the fiction category. So that was not possible, but I tried to do my best. I tried to include the books which I felt like they should be there in this video, and if I've missed any, do let me know in the comments down below. Don't hate me for that, it was unintentional. One book was very intentional. And thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you liked it, and if you did, do hit thumbs up and make sure you subscribe to my channel. And yes, that's it. This is Manvi signing off. I'll be back with another video very soon.